fascinated by nature. He has a mad desire to travel, and he is thirsting to travel far and wide. This poem is about his strong desire to travel. Beyond the east, the sunrise. Beyond the west, the sea. Beyond the east, beyond, farther away from the east, there is the sea, and beyond that, there is sunrise. Beyond the west, farther away from the west, there is the sea. And the east and the west, the wander thirst, that will not let me be. His desire to go beyond the east, the west, the south, and the north, to see and explore, will not allow him to stay in one place. He wants to travel to east and the west, to see, to explore, and to know. His desire to travel, it is like a madness in him. He wants to go beyond. It works in me like a madness, dear, to bid me say goodbye, for the seas call and the stars call, and oh, the call of the sky. So his desire to travel is like a madness. It is forcing him from within to say goodbye to his friends and to his family members. But the seas call and the stars call and the call of the sky. When he hears the call of the nature is tempting him to travel. The sky, the stars, and the birds are forcing him to travel. I know not where the white road runs, nor what the blue hills are. Easily, he doesn't know what the white road is or the blue hills are. He tells he is an inexperienced traveler. He is a stranger to many places. But a man can have the sun for a friend and for his guide a star. Although he is a stranger, he can take the sun as his friend and the star as his guide. And there is no end to voyaging. And when once the voice is heard, for the rivers call and the road calls, and oh, the call of the bird. A person is, once a person has heard the call of the river, the road, the sea, the sky, there is no end of traveling. Voyaging means traveling. Traveling on a long journey, going on a long journey, either by sea or by in space. So once the voice is heard, he cannot sit still. He has to travel. Yonder the long horizon lies, and there by night and day, the old ships draw to home again, the young ships sail away. Yonder, yonder means there, far, the long horizon lies. Horizon means the place, the line where the sky and the land meets. The poet stands at the seashore and she can see in the horizon the old ships are returning. When the ships are returning, it has already become old because it has gone on a long journey. The young ships sail away. When the ship starts departing, the ships are new. So he can see the old ships returning and the new ships going away. And come I may, but go I must. And if men ask you why, you may put the blame on the stars and the sun, and the white road and the sky. The poet says, and come I may come. My coming by is not sure, but go I must. But my going is certain, I must go. And if they are asking the reason, and is trying to blame me, he's telling, the poet is telling, you should blame the sun, the nature, the sun, the sky, the star, the road. That's that nature is calling him to travel. So this poem is basically telling about his intense desire to travel, to know and to explore. Some of the hard words I just explained to you. Want or thirst means the desire to explore, a strong desire to explore. Bid, command. Voyaging, a long journey by sea or space. Yonder, there. Horizon, the line where the sky and the land seem to meet. Thank you.